Yeah, hello everyone. Myself Vivek Kumar Gangadhara. I'm from Hyderabad. I have completed my graduation from Usmania University in the year of 2018. Also, I have completed my teacher training course in the year of 2015. So I have experience up to 6 years of experience in the present teaching field. And I have contact with this Urban Pro since last 1 year onwards. And in this one year, I have taught 100 plus students from different backgrounds of different learning styles like that. So many students I have taught. And at present, I am working as a private tutor with subjects in English and mathematics. And my main focus is on the spoken English, like how to teach the, how to frame the sentences, frame the sentences while speaking or writing in any gatherings like that. Okay, so yes, and at present I am pursuing my BEd program in the teaching field. Today, we are going to discuss about sentences in the English, particularly in the spoken English. So please see the presentation. So what are the topics I am going to be covered in the today's class? So that is, the first one is sentence introduction. Next, definition, that is meaning, with examples. Next, important rules to form a sentence. So what type of rules while speaking and while writing. Next, types of sentences. So what are the types of sentences? So like assertive sentence, next interrogative sentence, and next imperative sentences. So next, the last one is the exclamatory sentence. So these are the topics to be covered in the today's class. So without any further go, we shall see first of all what is the sentence. So generally, before going to the sentences, you see three examples. So the first one is, birthday is tomorrow mine. This is the first sentence. Next, the second one is, tomorrow is my birthday. The third one is, my birthday is tomorrow. I think so, this you can observe that birthday is tomorrow mine. So it was not at all giving any type of meaning. That means not framing any meaning, even though it is having a group of words, right, children? So here, like this, you can use. And actually, if you see the second and the third cases, okay, those two sentences are giving a proper meaning, exact meaning, and a proper arrangement. So tomorrow is my birthday. It is, for listening, it is very exact in the meaning. So like that, in the third case also, my birthday is tomorrow. So that is also giving a proper meaning, and the exact arrangement was there with a complete sense. So the word complete sense meaning, it will give a proper understanding of the sentence. Okay, so with this example, so we can able to tell the meaning of the sentence. So called definition. So the arrangement of group of words having complete sense is called a sentence. So here, having complete sense was marked with a bold letter. So that means, what is that? That is a very important thing. Every sentence should have a proper arrangement and should give a complete sense. Then only we can tell as a, that is a sentence, okay? So this type of sentences we can use in the while speaking or while writing, okay? So the next, you see the examples. The first one, I am going to Delhi tomorrow. Yes, we can understand very easily just by seeing this sentence. Second one, why are you waiting here? We can understand. So the arrangement of sentences is like that. Okay, next, the third one, fetch me a piece of chalk. So fetch me means bring me a piece of chalk. So generally in the schools, we will be using this sentence. Next, fourth one, what a beautiful climate. This is for our expression, sudden expression. What a beautiful climate. So these are some of the examples. Next, if you see important rules to form a sentence. So what type of rules will be both on the speaking and on the writing? So there will be some important rules. So we should follow them. So what are those? This is the first one. Every sentence should start with a capital letter. So like whenever we are writing, so this is for the writing. So compulsory we should start with a capital letter. Like Raju is my friend. So the highlighted word is a capital letter. So we should start. So many of you will start with a small letter, even if it is first letter also. Okay. So this was the first one we should remember. The next thing, every sentence should end with either full stop or question mark. So depending upon the situation, if we are telling any sentence, we should stop with full stop. Or else if we are asking anything, we should stop with the question mark. Like this one. Naresh likes to ride a bicycle. So bicycle after full stop was there. So highlighted with that. So full stop. Okay. Like this. This is second set rule. Next. When will you meet me? When will you meet me? Question mark. Either full stop or question mark. Okay. Next. The first letter of the sentence should not combine with the other letters of the first word. Okay, if you see the example, you can understand. So, whenever you are starting any sentence, so the first letter of the first word, you should not combine with other letter, like this. If you can see in the example, you can understand. Okay, so especially this will work out in the cursive handwriting type. Okay, so like that. Next, every sentence should be arranged in a proper order to mean something. So whenever you are writing or whenever you are speaking any type of sentence, it should give a proper order, okay, to give a correct meaning so that others can reply to your sentence or your question. Okay, these are some of the important rules. Next, tomorrow I will go to a movie. I will go to a movie. So this is giving a proper order to mean something. So just by seeing this sentence, we can understand. Yeah, tomorrow he will go to a movie thing. Like that we will be telling. Okay, next. So next we are going to see that is the types of sentences. So what types of sentences are there? Four types of sentences are there very importantly. So the first one is assertive sentence, interrogative sentence, imperative sentence, exclamatory sentence. Okay, next. The first one, assertive. What is this assertive sentence mean? So it is also called as declarative sentence or affirmative sentence. Declarative or affirmative, both are same word. Declarative, affirmative and assertive, three words are same. So declaring something, okay, telling any one point in a sure, okay, like that we can say. Okay, so definition, a sentence which asserts or declares something is called an assertive sentence, which asserts or declares either positive or negative. Okay, assertive sentence, it is again divided into two types. So what are they? Affirmative sentence, negative sentence. Here affirmative means a positive sentence. Okay, you can see in the next slide. Or a singular. So affirmative sentence, that is a positive sentences. So what type of sentences will be there? Which accepts the situation is called affirmative sentence. If you see the example, I eat rice. Yes, it is accepting the situation. So there, the positive sentence, the positive situation was there. I eat rice is a positive way of talking. So this is called an affirmative sentence or a declarative. Declaring a positive situation is called affirmative sentence. Next, I will go to temple. Here also accepting the positive situation. Next, negative sentence. Negative sentence, that is same like opposite. The sentence which doesn't accept the situation. Okay, that means negative words. Opposite situations, we will be using negative sentences. Like, I don't eat rice. I eat rice, opposite, I don't eat rice. Okay, negative. I won't go to temple. Okay, like this, we can use the negative sentences. Okay, next. I don't want to talk while eating food. Okay, these are the some the affirmative sentences, like positive or in the negative way. Okay, so compulsory, they will accept the situation or they won't, doesn't accept the situation. Okay, so this is about assertive sentence. Next, interrogative sentence. The sentence which questions about the situation are called interrogative sentences. Questioning situation are called interrogative. So it is also divided into two parts. So beginning with the WH type, beginning with helping verb. So WH type. So I think so, you know, WH questions generally from our primary schools onwards, we are dealing with the WH question, like what, when, where, which, why. Okay, these are some of the clue words for WH type question. And beginning with helping verb, these are somewhat new for higher grade children. Okay, like am, is, or was, were, have, has, had, next, do, did, does. Okay, if the sentence was starting with these type of helping verb, then these are called interrogative sentences with the helping verb. Okay. So if you see the examples like what is your name, these are the WH questions. What is your name? How are you feeling now? Whose book is this? Like that, we can able to say, we can able to ask to anyone. Okay. So this is generally we will be asking as a WH type question. Suppose if we want to ask in another way, so we can use in the helping verb. So am I right? Am I right, sir? Is there any place for me? Had your breakfast? Did any of you went to study? So like this, these examples you can take. So actually these are also questions only, but they will be starting with helping verbs. Helping verbs, like these are the clue words for helping verbs. Okay, so like this, you can able to compare, okay, the two different types of questions. Okay, next. If you see this next part, that is imperative sentence. Okay. So what is imperative sentence? The sentence which orders or requests or suggests something is called imperative sentences. Okay. Ordering, requesting, suggesting. So many of you will take the suggestions from others, like elders or from old younger people, like that, from doctors, from any other policemen, like that. Okay. So we shall see the example. It always begins with a verb. So compulsory, every imperative sentence will begin with a verb. Verb means action word, doing words. Okay, see the example. Fetch me a piece of chalk. This is the order. So generally in the schools, we will be listening this sentence. Your teachers might be saying, fetch me a piece of chalk. That means bring me a piece of chalk, beginning with a verb. This is the order type. Next, please go back to the place. It is a request type. Please, if you see me, you can tell it is a request type. Next, shoot at once, commanding. Generally in the military, air force, like that, you can see this type of words. Next, go to bed early. It is an advice. Advice from the doctors, advice from parents, like that. You can understand. And next, do regular exercise. Same, this is also advice from the doctors or from the parents or from any elders. Okay, like this, these are the some of the imperative sentences. Okay, next. The last one we are going to see is the exclamatory sentence. Okay, so what are these exclamatory sentences? The sentence which expresses our strong and sudden feelings and emotions. It's called exclamatory sentences. Strong and sudden feelings. Suddenly, if you are feeling anything, any type of behavior, so at the time, these exclamatory sentences will be used. So how we can use in the sentence part? You see the example. The first one. Wow, what a beautiful place. Wow, the term wow is an exclamatory word. Wow, what a beautiful place. So generally, if you see a Taj Mahal, you will be saying, wow, what a beautiful monument, like that you will be telling. So that is one type of sudden feeling or emotionally at the time. Next, second one, alas, he died in an accident. Alas, he died in an accident. So the word alas is used as an exclamatory, okay, in the sad, in the sorrow thing. Next, hooray, we won the match. Hooray, we won the match. Whenever you won the match, you will be telling, hooray. Okay, this is a type of sudden feeling, a strong feeling. Next, as a sentence, how cool the weather is, especially in the winter season, you will be telling, winter morning time, at early morning or at early evening time, you will be telling. So how cool the weather is. So like that, you can use the this type of sentences. So like this, totally all these types of sentences you can use in our daily life talking. So this is about class. Okay, fine. I think so. Most of you have understood what we have taken the today's class. Still, if you are having any type of doubts, you can contact me through the Arpan Pro. And once again, I am very much grateful to be with our Arpan Pro, and thank you for Arpan Pro to giving me this wonderful opportunity.